Hi, AT from CNC at home. A friend of mine who uses LightBurn and a laser exactly like mine, it's a Genmitsu LE5040, asked me the other day if it was possible to stop a burn right in the middle of it and then pick it up later and start burning again. The short answer is yes. The long answer is probably not something you should do. I want to cover just a few things that you can do if you don't want to or are unable to do a complete burn at the same time. There are a few things you can do with this particular machine where you can pause the burn and then pick it up later. Let's go over to the laser, get it started burning. And all I will do is first we'll do the frame option and then we'll get it started. We'll start by doing a frame that will outline where the burn is actually going to take place on our tile. That looks good. And let's go ahead and start the burn. So I'm clicking start. I don't plan on keeping this tile. This is one of the old tiles that I'd done the cold galvanizing compound on, and it just was too thick of a coat and it ends up not burning properly. It will work great for this experiment on how to do a burn and stop it and then pick it up later. And if it doesn't work so hot, not a big deal, we're not keeping it. Now's a good time to stop this, as I've been called to go outside and help get some stuff done in the garden. So, of the burn here, what I'm going to do is the pause button. Okay, so now the process is paused. And what my friend was talking about was a little more drastic than just stopping it for a minute or two. He was talking about actually shutting things down. In this particular experiment or this example, I'm going to shut the laser off, but I'm going to leave the computer running. The way that I have my system set up, I have my power management. It's just a power bar with switches on it. So I'm going to turn off the LE5040. So the power's off. And we see that the power to the computer is still running. You see here, we're kind of at 17%, but we are paused. I just clicked on the pause button here, and when I click on it again, it will resume the burn. So we'll just stop the video for a minute while we do this. I'll shut things down, get the exhaust fan shut down, and I will come back to this in a little bit. I'm back in from helping out with the garden. So what I'm going to do is turn the laser back on, and then I will click the resume button here. This particular method is not going to work with every laser. With the SainSmart LE5040, there is no homing option with it. There's no limit switches, and the computer basically sends signals to it, and there's no feedback for positioning. So if it says move an inch or 5 millimeters, the signal is sent. If the laser moves, it moves. If it doesn't, the computer assumes that it did. That's why we can get away with leaving the computer on, shutting the laser off, and then when we're ready to resume, we just turn the laser back on and resume our cutting. There are other methods that we can use if you know ahead of time that you're going to need to stop a burn or you want to do it in smaller sections, and I can touch on those. We'll just watch the rest of this burn, I guess. Thank you. Here we have the completed tile, and over here where we stopped, everything looks good. There weren't any weird movements or anything. Let's take a look at another possible way to control starting and stopping if you know ahead of time that you're going to be doing that. The way I'm going to do this one is I'm going to first tell the laser to go to its home position. So I simply just select the go to origin, and it thinks that's where the origin is because that's where I told it was. What I'm going to do is, for the sake of argument, if I had limit switches, I could bring the gantry all the way forward, and all the way to the left. That's my lower left-hand corner, and that can be my zero point. Because I physically moved the laser, it still thinks it's at the 0-0, or the computer thinks it's at the 0-0. Let's go take a look at the screen here real quick. All right, if we look over here, I have LightBurn set to absolute coordinates. My origin is my lower left-hand corner. And I have placed a tile template out here with three shapes on it. Each one of those shapes is in its own layer. So what I want to do is I want to move the laser head, because it thinks it's down here. I want to move it to this spot. To do that, I come over here to this little teardrop guy, and that's the set laser position by clicking on the page. So I just select that, and then I come over here to this corner, and I click on that. Now let's go take a look at the laser. All right, now that's where it thinks the lower right-hand corner of a tile should be. So I'm going to turn the laser on to its 1% setting and put another tile in there so that the corner lines up with where the laser dot is. So you can see the laser dot on here. We'll just bring that up and set it right there. Now, to know if this is square with the laser, I have a little macro that I can run. So I just go to my controls and I click my X-axis macro, and that moves this across. And we can see that we're getting further and further away from the edge. So I rotated it slightly this way. Now let's run that again real quick while I'm paying attention. Well, it's still going. We'll see how we're squared up now that it's coming back. Okay. A couple millimeters off that bottom edge. Fairly consistently. I'm going to do just a little bit more, and we should be square. Laser on. Okay. So the laser's just at that corner, so I'm going to take the whole tile and move it up. And again, I'm doing that so that our coordinate system is based off the lower left-hand corner of my laser's working area. Let's go back and take a look at the screen, and I'll show you what we can do now. Okay, I'm going to zoom in on the laser controls here, and I want to highlight or show you an option. Right here we have an option called Cut Selected Graphics. If for some reason we know we want to break up our burn into multiple steps, or if we want to redo just one little step, if we have objects that we're burning versus just one image, I can come in and I can select that one object. So we have the circle selected. We can even see this in our preview, that when we do our burn, well, hang on, I need to tell it. I'm going to turn this on. Cut selected graphics. Now when we do our preview, it's just the circle. If I had my hexagon and the circle selected. We can go into preview. It's just those two items. If I had just my square and I go into preview, it's going to do just the square. So the nice thing about that is I can control what I'm burning this time. And because I oriented down here, I know where this is when I've saved this, I could burn this circle, do a totally different project, come back to this and do the same process. Take my laser and physically orient it down in the lower left-hand corner, make sure that that's my origin, and then tell it to come here, orient my tile back on my working area so that it's square and that my lower left-hand corner of the tile is right where I want it to be, and then I could burn one of the other shapes. So that's another method that you can use to control your burning when you know that you're going to be doing that or needing to do that. By only selecting the square, that will be the only thing that burns. What I want to simulate is stopping the burn after this one object and then resetting the machine. So what I'm going to do is remove my tile and then let the laser head go back to its origin. Then I will move it to a few different spots. We'll just pretend that we did something and then we'll get it oriented back in the lower left-hand corner of the tile that I'm going to continue burning. This last move then is to that lower left-hand corner of the tile. So let's put the tile back in here and we'll go through the alignment process just like we did last time. Make sure that it's square and in the appropriate spot. Once that's done, I'm going to select the circle and the hexagon. And then we'll go ahead and start the burn just on these two items. Simple as that. It's a very powerful feature and can come in very handy as you're doing burns of various types. So by selecting the item, and making sure that we have the options set within LightBurn to just burn the selected objects, we can control what gets burned for each job that we send to it. We can also pause the job as we showed with our first tile burn. These are some powerful features and can really help. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and think about subscribing. As always, enjoy doing your CNC at home projects.